إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. أما بعد، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد، respected brothers and sisters in Islam, as Muslims will live our lives being grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every single moment of the day. We don't wait for an occasion or a day of the year or a month or a week or a special week in the year. But we have to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every single moment that we live. And being grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not just saying it, but saying it and acting upon it as well. How to act upon it is by following the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when we think about the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon us and His bounties upon us, we will never be able to thank Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam narrated or said, talking about his Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, in a hadith as is narrated by Abi Dharr al-Ghifari عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فيما يرويه عن ربه عز وجل قال: يا عبادي، إني حرمت الظلم على نفسي وجعلته بينكم محرما فلا تظالموا. يا عبادي، كلكم ضال إلا من هديته فاستهدوني أهدكم. يا عبادي، كلكم جائع إلا من أطعمته فاستطعموني أطعمكم. يا عبادي، كلكم عار إلا من كسوته فاستكسوني أكسكم. يا عبادي، إنكم تخطئون بالليل والنهار وأنا أغفر الذنوب جميعا فاستغفروني أغفر لكم. يا عبادي، إنكم لن تبلغوا نفعي فتنفعوني ولن تبلغوا ضري فتضروني. يا عبادي، لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم كانوا على أتقى رجل واحد منكم ما زاد ذلك في ملكي شيئا. ولو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم كانوا على قلب أفجر رجل واحد منكم ما نقص ذلك من ملكي شيئا. يا عبادي، لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم قاموا على صعيد واحد فسألوني فأعطيت كل إنسان مسألته ما نقص ذلك من ملكي إلا كما ينقص المخيط إذا أدخل البحر. يا عبادي، إنما هي أعمالكم أحصيها لكم فمن وجد خيرا فليحمد الله. إنما هي أعمالكم أحصيها لكم ثم أوفيكم إياها فمن وجد خيرا فليحمد الله ومن وجد غير ذلك فلا يلومن إلا نفسه. In a hadith collected by Muslim رحمه الله, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, as narrated by Abi Dharr al-Ghifari, He's saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and he's talking to us as his servants, as his obedient Muslims, those who submitted to him subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's reminding us about his blessings and bounties upon us and what we are supposed to do. Dear brothers and sisters, if we are thankful, we are thankful to Allah, but for the benefit of ourselves. If we are ungrateful, we are ungrateful to Allah, but for the harm of ourselves. Nothing will benefit Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nor anything will harm Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever we do in this life, it's either for us or against us. If it's a good deed, then it will be beneficial to us on the day of judgment. If it's a bad deed, it will be harmful to us on the day of judgment. Dear brothers and sisters, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us that your Lord is saying, O my servants, the meaning of the words, O my servants, verily I made transgression haram upon myself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He made transgression haram upon himself first. And then he said, I made it upon yourself haram as well. فَلَا تَظَّلَمُوا. Don't transgress. Don't commit transgression. What is the worst of the transgression that we commit and mankind commit is that when they worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ. Verily, associating with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a great shirk. And mind you, brothers and sisters, that some of us as Muslims, sometimes we commit it, knowing or not knowing. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with something and we thank someone else other than Allah, then we are associating with Allah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests us with a calamity or a test, we go and complain to other than Allah. When we ask other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are in problems and troubles, and we make dua. Some of the Muslims make dua to the dead people and ask even the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for help and support. That is wal'iyadu billah, associating with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna shirka la zulmun azim. Verily, it's a great transgression. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says after that, Ya ibadi, kullukum dallun illa man hadaytum. When you think about it, brothers and sisters, that you are here and you're listening to me now, you would say this is the greatest blessing that I have as a Muslim, the blessing of guidance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states here, you are all astray except the ones whom I guide. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says it in the Quran to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who wished and hoped for his family members and relatives to be guided. إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتِ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Verily, you don't guide those whom you love to guide, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide whomever he wishes. And this is the best of the best of the best that we can get. The blessing of guidance. Now the question that comes, brothers and sisters, is, am I as a Muslim grateful to Allah enough, grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this blessing, for making me a Muslim, for guiding me to Islam? When we look around us, we are minority wherever you go. We are minority in the world. We are minority in this land as well. We are very few, 8 to 9%. Very few, 8 to 9 millions of the Muslims among 360 million Muslim human beings on this land. We are few, which means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose you and I to be Muslims, which means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed me, which means I have to be grateful and thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first and foremost. How do I be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this? Is by fulfilling the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and devote myself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and stick to the straight path, because that is the purpose of my existence. That is the purpose of my creation. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. ما أريد منهم من رزق وما أريد أن يطعمون. We have not created for anything else, brothers and sisters, except to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we can turn our jobs and our professions and our businesses into an act of worship by having the sincere intention. When we go into our work, we are going with sincerity to fulfill what we have to fulfill in the right way. And then to sustain our families and ourselves from that which is halal, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant me and showed me the way to get it. Dear brothers and sisters, there is no better blessing than the blessing of guidance. Thus, every single day, we repeat it and we ask and we beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for it on a daily basis. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. Oh Allah, guide us to the straight path. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make it a pillar of the salah that you recite Surah Al-Fatiha. You have to recite it. If you don't recite it, your salah is not valid. So you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guidance, to guide you on a daily basis at the minimum of 17 times that we repeat it, because there is no better blessing than the blessing of guidance. But there are rights that comes with it, the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the rights of His Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the rights of those who are around us. For non-Muslims to call them to Islam, and for the Muslims to enjoin that which is good and forbid that which is evil. When we see something wrong, we talk about it. We stop it from happening among the Muslims. And we enjoin that which is good. We call to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya ibadi kullukum dallun illa man hadaytu. And the best thing that happens to us is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described in the Quran. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوعَدُونَ. To the end of the ayah. Those who say, my Lord is Allah, or our Lord is Allah, and He stays steadfast. If my Lord is Allah, I have to know the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon me. His rights upon me, and I should work hard and strive and struggle to fulfill them, according, of course, to my ability. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. Allah will not burden you with more than you can bear and than you can take. So we fulfill the right of my Lord when I say, my Lord is Allah. When I say, La ilaha illallah, what does it mean to me as a Muslim? He is my creator, and no one deserves my worship except Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing comes before Him subhanahu wa ta'ala and before His rights. No profession, no business, no job, no family, no one, even my own self, does not come before the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are fulfilled. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says the second blessing after the greatest blessing of guidance. كلكم جائع إلا من أطعمته وكلكم عار إلا من كسوته. يا عبادي. Oh my, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gently calling us, Ya ibadi, oh my servant, listen, you are all hungry except those whom I feed. Dear brothers and sisters, when you think about just waking up in the morning, things that we take for granted, we wake up in the morning, we make wudu, we pray, we have our breakfast, and then we get in our cars and we go to work, and we work, and then they get the paycheck and put it in the bank, and life goes on. Did you ever think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you every single thing that you are doing? He grants you the ability to do it. He grants you the arms, the legs, the brain, the eyes, the sight, the hearing. Are you grateful enough to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Are you grateful when you get that sustenance, that money, or that food? Do you think where it comes from? Do you think about the one who is sustaining you with it as long as you live? You go through hardship and you find yourself finding sources that helps you and supports you. Did you think, where did it come from? It's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as stated in this hadith. كُلُّكُمْ عَارٍ إِلَّا مَنْ كَسَوْتُهُ. You are all hungry if I don't feed you, and you are all without clothes if I don't clothe you. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says a great thing to show His infinite mercy subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَا عِبَادِي إِنَّكُمْ تُخْطِئُونَ بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ وَأَنَا أَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا فَاسْتَغْفِرُونِي أَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ. O my servants, you make mistakes and you sin day and night, and I forgive all the sins. So seek my forgiveness and I shall forgive you. And more than this, to clarify this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in an ayah in the Quran that is considered the most hopeful ayah in the Quran. قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. O my servant, those who transgressed against themselves, don't despair, ever despair from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Never despair from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives all the sins. And this is what Allah is offering us. The only condition is that we take a step towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask for His forgiveness sincerely. And He will wipe it off. As narrated by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to his companions, there was a man of Banu Israel who killed 99 people. And he felt the urge of tawbah, of repenting and going back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he asked about the scholar of the region. They guided him to a monk. So he went to him and he asked, is there any tawbah for me? I killed 99 people. He told him no, out of ignorance. He told him no, because he's just a worshipper, he's not a scholar. So he killed him as well. It's become 100. Then he asked for another scholar. They guided him to another one. He went to him and he asked him, is there any repentance for me? Is there any way that I can wipe all these sins? He said, yes, the door is open. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives the sins day and night until the soul reaches the throat or the sun comes up from the west. That's when the tawbah is not accepted only. When the person is about to die or when the sun comes from the west, which is a major sign of the Day of Judgment. And he told him, leave this filthy place where you sinned and corrupt place. Go to righteous people and stay with them. And then repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and your repentance will be accepted inshallah. So he took off and he left the place. Midway, the angel of death came to him and the angels of mercy came to him, the angels of forgiveness came to him and of punishment came to him. And then they were arguing who is going to take his soul. He just killed 100 people. He has to be punished. The other group says, no, he is repenting and he changed his way and his path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent another angel to judge between them. He told them to measure the place between that place and where he is going, where he's coming from and where he's going. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expanded the earth and he was under the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he was saved. This is a person who killed 100 people. And this is an authentic hadith, an authentic narration of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We haven't done any of that. So what are we waiting for, brothers and sisters, to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek His forgiveness if His mercy is this expanded? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says after that, Ya ibadi, innakum lan tablughu naf'i fatanfa'uni wa lan tablughu darri fatadurruni. Whatever we do, brothers and sisters, we can't brag about it because it's all from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever we do, brothers and sisters, it's not going to benefit Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as stated in this hadith. Whatever of evil we do, it's not going to harm, affect Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's above all this. Whatever we do, it's for us of good. And whatever of evil we do, then it's against us. And that's what Allah stated, subhanahu wa ta'ala stated at the end of this hadith Qudsi. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم، فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله الواحد الأحد البر الصمد، الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفواً أحد. الحمد لله غافر الذنب قابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول، لا إله إلا هو الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الحمد لله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله مالك يوم الدين. ربنا اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. أما بعد، dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, the door of forgiveness and a door of mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always open. It never closes. However, we have to strive and struggle against two evil forces, the evil of the shaitan and the evil of ourselves, the inner evil that we have that drags us to our desires. We have to struggle against the two. But when we strive and struggle, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help us and support us. And he's, as he described in the Quran, وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَمَعَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. If you strive, if you try, Allah will guide you. It's a promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you try, strive, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide you to the straight path. But we have to come with that effort. We have to come with that energy to do it. And it all depends on us as individual. As individuals, we have to work on our own selves and suppress our desires and seek refuge in Allah from the shaitan. And that's the easy war. إِنَّ كَيْدَ الشَّيْطَانِ كَانَ ضَعِيفًا. Verily, the plot of the shaitan is weak. And by the way, brothers and sisters, on the day of judgment, we cannot blame the shaitan. We cannot. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us the story in the Quran. And the shaitan will say, I'm free from you. I just called you, whispered to you, and you followed me. I didn't force you to do what you did. I just whispered to you. And you أنا بريء. I'm free from what you did. مَا أَنَا بِمُصْرِخِكُمْ وَمَا أَنْتُمْ بِمُصْرِخِي. Now you cannot save me, I cannot save you. We are both in trouble. But I just whispered to you and you followed. But subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us an easy solution. وَإِمَّا يَنْزَغَنَّكَ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ نَزْغٌ فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ. Go to the powerful one against the weak one. Go to the creator against the creation. The shaitan is a creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The creator is Allah. So seek refuge in Allah and the shaitan will be nothing to fight. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this hadith says, and subhanAllah, to show the greatness of the treasures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم قاموا على صعيد واحد فسألوني فأعطيت كل إنسان مسألته. If all of you, from Adam عليه السلام to the last person on the earth, stands on a one valley, and all of them ask me for whatever they want and they need, and I give each and every one what they need and what they ask for and what they want, that will not take anything from my kingdom. Nothing. It will be like you take a needle, as the hadith describes, and put it in the ocean and pull it out of the ocean and see how much that needle, how much of water that needle will take from the ocean. And imagine how many billions lived on this earth. Billions lived on this earth. If they ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will grant them their dua. Oh Allah, grant me this and this and this and that. You will, here you go, here you go. And nothing will change in the kingdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It will not be diminished. It will not decrease. This is how wide and how huge the treasures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are. We just have to take this step and ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, sincerely ask Him. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala concluded this hadith with something that we have to reflect on all the time. All the time, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, اتَّقِ اللَّهَ حَيْثُ مَا كُنْتِ اتَّقِ اللَّهَ حَيْثُ مَا كُنْتِ وَأَتْبِعِ السَّيِّئَةَ الْحَسَنَةَ تَمْحُهَا وَخَالِقِ النَّاسَ بِخُلُقٍ حَسَنٍ. Be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wherever you are. Because you don't know when is the second that the angel of death will come to you. You don't know. No, none of us knows. No one knows when the angel of death will come. So we'll have to be conscious and mindful that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching over us. And He is waiting for our meeting as well. We don't know when we are going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we'll have to be conscious. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says at the end, إِنَّمَا هِيَ أَعْمَالُكُمْ أُحْصِيهَا لَكُمْ ثُمَّ أُوَفِّيكُمْ إِيَاهَا. Verily, this is only what you do, and I'm just recording it for you and counting it for you. And then I will give it back to you on the day of judgment. اقرأ كتابك كفى بنفسك اليوم عليك حسيب. On the day of judgment, we'll be given our books. Our books. We author the books now, brothers and sisters, on this earth. We are the writers, the authors. And we will read our own books of good deeds and bad deeds. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell us, كَفَى بِنَفْسِكَ الْيَوْمَ عَلَيْكَ حَسِيبًا. Your own self is enough to judge you. Take your book, read it, and tell me what you deserve. This is in our language. And tell me what you deserve, what you get. Do you pass or do you fail? May Allah protect us from failure in that moment. So, dear brothers and sisters, the conclusion was, فَمَنْ وَجَدَ خَيْرًا فَلْيَحْمَدِ اللَّهِ وَمَنْ وَجَدَ غَيْرَ ذَلِكَ فَلَا يَلُومَنَّ إِلَّا نَفْسَهِ. Very scary statement. Whoever finds something good in that book, then let him or her praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at the very beginning of the hadith. كُلُّكُمْ ضَالٌ إِلَّا مَنْ هَدَيْتُهُ فَمَنْ وَجَدَ خَيْرًا فَلْيَحْمَدِ اللَّهِ. You are all misguided except if I guide you. If you find good in your book, then praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because He is the one who guided you to find good in your book. وَمَنْ وَجَدَ خَيْرَ ذَلِكَ فَلَا يَلُومَنَّ إِلَّا نَفْسَهُ. And whoever finds anything else other than good, then let him or her blame no one but themselves. Why? Because وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I did not create you to do anything else but to worship me. And that doesn't mean sit in the masjid and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No, we can worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while working, while driving, with sincere intention. That we are doing what we are doing, we can worship Allah while sleeping. If we go to sleep with the intention of waking up for Fajr, that night is a kind of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dear brothers and sisters, time doesn't stop and it goes quickly and fast. And Allah swear that the time is very important and we cannot wait. Wal asr, innal insana lafi khusr. If we wait, we'll be among the losers. If we wait for time, I'll do this next day, next week, next month. When I get married, when I get children, when my children get married, when they graduate, when I get a better job, and so on and so forth. The excuse that we give and our children take from us and learn and apply as well. And life goes on. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. We can't wait. Time goes. The clock is ticking. Doesn't stop. وَالْعَصْرِ. Allah swear by the time. All mankind are in a state of loss except. And He put conditions, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The conditions are four. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Those who believe. And that's not enough. Belief is in my heart, but I have to prove it with action. وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. And I cannot stop there by myself. وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ. I have to enjoin that which is truthful and call to it and enjoin that which is good, which means I cannot live by myself. I can't. I have to live with my brothers and sisters in Islam. And we have to support and help one another to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. تواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. And I have to advise and give the advice of being patient upon the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And encourage people and help them and support them to stay on the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this surah, subhanallah, Al-Imam al-Shafi'i, he said that if this is the only surah that was revealed from the Quran, it should be enough. Believe, do righteous good, enjoin the truth, and encourage people to be patient upon the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be patient, resist the temptation of the shaitan, and be patient upon the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The three types of patience that Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah described. As-sabru ala al-ta'a, as-sabru ani al-ma'asiyah, as-sabru ala aqdari Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll be patient upon worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we'll be successful and we'll not be among the losers, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم تب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم اللهم آت أنفسنا تقواها زكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية في الدين وفي الدنيا وفي الآخرة ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم تقبل توبتنا واغفر ذنبنا يا أرحم الراحمين يا أكرم الأكرمين يا رب العالمين وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وصحابته أجمعين ربنا اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولوالد الوالدين ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات ربنا اغفر لنا وارحمنا وتب علينا واهدنا وتبثنا اللهم أحينا على الإسلام على الإيمان وأمتنا على الإسلام يا أرحم الراحمين يا أكرم الأكرمين يا رب العالمين وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
هذا لا هذا استووا واعتدلوا يرحمكم الله استووا واعتدلوا الله أكبر الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى. الله أكبر الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. هل أتاك حديث الغاشية وجوه يومئذ خاشعة عاملة ناصبة تصلى نارا حامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم. الله أكبر.